Welcome back to Tell Me About Yourself, the series where I sit down with teachers and talk to them about their work lives, their personal lives, and how each of those have been affected by the coronavirus. This episode, I sat down with Mr. Scrable, who has been teaching math at Cromont for what is now his 14th year and has taught 26 years of math overall.
Just like, tell me a bit about yourself.
I'm a huge music fan, and you know, that's, people know that by seeing all the posters in my room. It's weird to say because I'm a lot older than what I'm about to say, but you know, my favorite shows, TV shows still to this day, are The Simpsons and Beavis and Butthead. You know, and then now my, I used to play a lot of computer games too, but you know, you get married and you lose some time for that. So I don't get to play that as much, but now that's kind of morphed into a good amount of online poker playing that has been pretty successful for me. So
I've been in your class and I know you have a bunch of sayings. What's your most famous saying and what does it mean?
The one that everyone associates with me, if they've ever had me, is just my relentless harping on bad algebra. And I just always say that it's the downfall of a student. Now, all the students have seen me throw many little tantrums about it, you know, banging my fists on the smart board or something about, you know, it's like, no, you can't possibly do this. This is what's killing you, you know, et cetera. Hideous algebra, absolutely hideous. This is not this power raised that power. You know, like, well, I mean, what's the all-time classic? X plus Y, you know, there's a simple one. X plus Y and you, in parentheses square, and they'll say it's X squared plus Y squared. I mean, that is just, it's inevitable they're going to say that.
So I know you've like taught for a long time at Cromont, and I'm sure that your like teaching style has been similar throughout the years. And so since we've all moved into distance learning, how has that changed your style of teaching?
You know, not as much as you would think. I think it's affected me less. What it has done is, you know, I've done it all through videos, but even in the spring, students would kind of tell me and say, you know, your videos are just like sitting in your class. And it's true, even though I'm recording by myself, I ask the same questions that I would ask in class. And I know there's going to be a common answer, a trap that they're going to fall into, you know, and I say, let me guess. You said blah, you know, and I'll even though there's no one there, and I'm like, are you kidding me? You can't say that because of this, you know. So, but I certainly miss the banter in class, being able to joke with the students a little bit, you know, and that part is a bummer. So that I do look forward to, you know, eventually getting back to real school again, where that would come in. So what is it? Come on. As if I'm talking to an empty classroom. What is it, damn it?
So I remember in one of your videos, you talked about how the Scribbles love going to Costco. And so what do you think is the best value buy at Costco?
Oh, man. Oh, that's a good question. I know what my wife thinks is the best value buy, which is pretty much anything in the jewelry section. She will say is the best value buy that you can get. When I'm thinking for me, dang, man. God, that's tough. They're all good buys, you know? I love cereal. So like, you know, I gravitate towards that one all the time, you know? I could spend forever in that aisle. But you know, is that the absolute best deal? I'm not sure, you know? I mean, hell, the toilet paper is a really, really good deal. What, you get like 30 rolls in there? You know, and especially for pandemic. So maybe you go for that. Oh, actually, you know what? I thought of a better one. Now that I think about it. The best deal is taking your kids through all of the samples. And I can almost feed them a lunch through those samples. And I've paid zero. So if you want to talk about that, that's like an infinite amount of percent off. So there you go. All right.
Thanks again to Mr. Scrable for letting me interview him. And for Scott Center, this is Ethan Mann.